I'm definitely producing tons of data every day. I think about my morning routine. First thing that I do is hop on my Peloton because I'm obsessed with closing my rings. After my workout, I'll head down to the kitchen and prepare breakfast. I'll make sure that I'm logging in every meal into that app. And then after that, I'm on my computer the rest of the day for work.
We are living in a society that increasingly is being powered by the data that you and I are creating every day. The internet is free, but the currency in the internet economy is your data.
It's a convenient economy, but we never checked to see, great, what did we give up to get that convenience?
There are large technology companies that are making multi-billion dollar transactions off of our data every day.
Your data is so valuable, but you are not a part of that final conversation, particularly when the money is being exchanged.
Imagine a world where you own and control who has access to your data and you also get compensated for it. If people are making money off your data, so should you.
Ka-ching, you have been paid.
That's really the idea of Streamlytics. That's how it started, and that's where we're going.
Hey, Mandar.
Hey, B, how are you?
I'm well. I'm excited. I heard you're going to be teaching me everything I need to know about the data economy.
I hope to be able to explain the balance of it all and you know, the dirty side as well.
Let's go to a site you trust. There is a right click button, click that, and then you'll see inspect. Go to application. Oh, there you go. You can see the world of cookies. So B, think about it like this, right? If something moves across sites, right? Banana Republic or HBR.com, you're essentially being tracked. That's how a third-party cookie works. Somebody you didn't trust started to collect data about you. And imagine, right, on an everyday basis, you're buying a dress, you could be buying a car. So your data starts becoming worth that much more, right? And so the idea of the data economy is, without B ever knowing, B has now become a product. It's a marketplace. It's a marketplace of bees who are people who are getting traded every day in that ecosystem.
My mind is being blown and I'm paranoid all at the same time.
And at no point of time did you realize that HBR asked you for your permission.
Now we've kind of been trained to actually just accept terms of services and now accept all cookies in order to just get access to a website.
That's just how business works. You can't escape these guys. The question is, who do you trust and who do you not trust? And at that end, it's a race to the bottom. And unless there is controls put back into it, I think we are going to be in trouble.
Streamlytics helps everyday people own and monetize their personal data, and then we help companies who are looking to leverage data ethically get access to that data.
I think before Streamlytics, I didn't know much about how to take back my data or even the process of like getting on these websites that I'm always on and literally triggering the pull for my data. I upload data from everything from Uber Eats to Netflix, wherever and whatever I'm consuming the most, that's the data I want to be intentional about uploading. It actually breaks down the process of like, how do you go to every respective website to pull that data? You then just simply upload that data set. And then it takes a couple of days for them to let you know how much you earned off that particular data set. In total, I probably made upwards of like $600.
If you want to upload your data every week, if you want to upload it every month, it's completely up to you. And that kind of control is revolutionary.
It's equipping us with information that enables us to ask better questions, informed questions, and ultimately, I think that's what accountability looks like for these companies.
The data that we're acquiring right now is 98% from the African American community. But the goal is really to do that in other fast-growing communities around the world. Streamlytics has a lot of really great ideas and concepts that people are using now around data privacy, data ownership, data portability, but how do we really make that law? How do we make that a standard? And that's where clearance comes in.
So, you know, there's a saying up here in Washington, D.C. that information is currency. And what that information is almost doesn't matter. But if I know something that you don't know, then I'm in the value position. So it has intrinsic value as well as monetary value because it tells a story about who we are. My name is Clarence Williams. I work with Streamlytics on data privacy issues to bring their big ideas to Washington, D.C.
Right now, the United States is the largest westernized country that doesn't have a federal data privacy law. Even China has one. So the question is, how progressive, from a technology perspective, is the United States?
Streamlytics gives you the ability to say, okay, we have a jump-off point. We can start from here.
Google is deprecating the cookie, which means they're completely getting rid of it. The world is really moving away from third-party cookies and why first-party data really is so essential in the future of where everything is going. Streamlytics is really part of this transition between Web 2.0, which is like super social media heavy, companies are using your data, to Web 3. It's decentralized, it's privacy first, where people who are using the technologies have ownership and control over their data.
Truly, it's about leveling the playing field and knowing that everyone has access. Most importantly, everyone knows how to get paid from that data. And I think that, for me, is the future state of where Streamlytics has the opportunity to take us to.